up lads, welcome back to Let's Play Inazuma 11 Go Galaxy. Now it's better than ever because Adé Kébé is going to be here with us and we've actually given him a blocking move. His final level up moveset in this game is Whirlpool, which actually got buffed quite a lot, so eventually Adé will have a very good blocking move, but not within the levels that we're going to be using him for. So I've given him his old move, Killer Whale, via move manual. He will get Flying Fish at level 27. He's currently level 24, and that's worth keeping in mind because right now, I've saved in the very first few seconds of the video before I've even done anything, so it's fine. We are currently level 26, and the next opponent is going to be level 30. So we're actually quite at our leisure to do as many random encounters as we want. There is a reason they've set the next level so high. That will become apparent in a little bit. I actually really want to purchase Air Ride and give it to someone immediately. Fun enough, Spinning Cut is back. That feels like a move that was sorely missing because it's very iconically Inazuma. So many different characters have had that in the anime. I actually gave that to Jordan Greenway in my playthrough of Supernova. Land of Ice has finally been nerfed. It was like 160 power or something crazy in Chrono Stones. Now it's only 80, but that would actually make a ton of sense to have on Shawn Froste. For once in my life, I'll actually give Land of Ice to someone that it's appropriate to, rather than to someone it's completely unfitting on, like Axel or something. So pretty much I want all of these, except for Dragster, which we've already got on Peabody. But Air Ride, I'm going to use immediately, because I think there's a very fitting candidate for that move. Maybe that's just because I gave it to him in Supernova and got used to it, but Falco has already been getting quite a bit of emphasis in this chapter. So, same type attack bonus, 110 power, taken from Little Gigantes. I want to give you Air Ride. That looks fantastic on Falco. He has not gained another move for a while. Parkour Power was the only thing he had with its weird power of 121. And he wouldn't be gaining any moves for quite some time. They're all pretty much locked behind story events. So you could get him to level 100 and he'd still look like this. Shawn Froste is going to have the complete set. He's got a shot at 80 power. He's got a dribble at 130. And now he's also going to have a block at 80, which of course used to be worth a lot more. Where's it gone again? Oh, it was right at the top. Oh, I see. It's already in his level up moveset, and as a result, I can't give it to him. Okay, well, never mind. I guess I won't cheat then. We'll just have some characters who can't do everything in the world, which is really the fair way of doing things. You can get some boots, you can get some bracelets, or you can just carry on with your life. Because, like, you know, we're all getting older, and There's a great degree of things to experience in this world. Just like, add up. What's all the countries you've been to in your life? How many? I'm only on about five, but add them up, and then you may discover room for opportunity. Are you thinking of, like, going to college or university? Yeah, just go for it. You've got my full support. This life is here to be lived, and do with it what you want. There you go, that's my very strange piece of vague life advice coming into effect. Anyway, so Shawn Froste is going to take the opportunity to do what I want, and that's Eternal Blizzard. Yeah! Look, it's frozen. Here I go, I'm going to spin twice and I'm going to batter it with my foot. Remember that time TaleOfTheToaster did Eternal Blizzard in his Inazuma 11 IRL Hisatsus video that didn't look a great deal like me Eternal Blizzard at all. That's how you're meant to do it, but I appreciate him having a go anyway. I'll give him me speed booster. That's a gift from Aiden. Well, that was pretty dark, actually. I'm so used to the Orion timeline where he exists that I kind of forgot. Yo, what if he didn't? You know, like, in the entire rest of the series. This is a bit of a secret path underneath, but it contains some noble boots. Dragster, the one thing that we didn't buy, we've been compensated on anyway. I thought that was going to be a photo, but it's not. So back out we go. And maybe, now that we've stolen from the planet's resources, we will finally immigrate. That's been the plot point for far too long now. Now we're going to talk about pasta. Ha! Special cooking! That was kind of a Hotel Mario Luigi voice, but referencing the TV show. Planet is screaming from the depths of its oceans. You! I made all that up, but didn't it sound super cool? Well, if I was reading the whole thing out loud, then it certainly would have. Here we are then, it's time for the Adé Kébé debut with the killer wheel that I've given to him off screen. I'm underneath the water, what you gonna do? Ah, nice water, here we go. And then I'd love to do a flying fish for you, but unfortunately, I can't. So what I'll do instead, I'll do another killer wheel, and it'll be even better the second time. Yeah, look at this, lads. How are you, Pet? How are we doing? I am recording this from within Newcastle-upon-Tyne. Heck, I could even be out in the city right now. I did have an invite, but I'm like, no, I want to record Inazuma 11 Go Galaxy, because I haven't done that for a month. So now it's over to me. Cheers for that one, Adé. I think we make a bit of a great team, we do. The power of Yorkshire and Newcastle combined makes Tale of the Toaster, basically. I'm from Yorkshire natively, which is where Shawn Froste's accent comes from. And then I moved to Newcastle where Adé lived. So the two of them combined are basically me, and they've got us some antifreeze cream, which is a nice thought, I suppose. Anyway, that husband of mine always making me wait. What kind of loving husband does that? I guess he's right over here, probably, is he? No, never mind. That was the most nothing conversation I may have encountered in the whole game, I think. The main reason, of course, I've been doing a couple of random encounters to see who will be added to the Pal Pack Society, but all of the people that we played against in the story-required match, which didn't seem like it was a necessary win, but the dialogue certainly suggested that we'd lost it, but I'm pretty sure you do need to win that match. I guess I'm kind of doubting myself right now, but I know I've lost it before, and I think you have the option to do it again. But yes, you can recruit all those people, just their conditions aren't the easiest by any means. Let's finally emigrate. Hello, sirs and madams, this is the immigration desk. This is a plot point so unimportant that they didn't even give the customs worker an icon. In fact, their name is Receptionist. So, but here we are. What? But I haven't done anything yet. Next, please. Didn't even remember to fill out your passenger locator form. Oh my! What is it? What's with your ether? I've never seen anything like this before. Ether? Oops. Don't worry about it. Next, please! What the? People from Naiadi always seem to know what's going on. But what Glacia said, what's their fearsome strength? It's their tightly knit visa policy. Yes, that's what's keeping them safe. Princess Relaya! Long live Phalamorbius!
Victor, it's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
What? That's... Mummy!
It looks like she's lost.
Get over there and ease her. It's not a nice sight.
Huh? What?
It's not nice for a child to be upset like that.
I see.
Mommy! What are you doing, Globulus? She's still crying.
That's true, but...
Oh, honey, there you are!
Mommy!
This looks kind of like Faerun. Is this in a different time period? Maybe this is Faerun's distant ancestor. You never know. He's got to have one somewhere in this timeline. If Zanuck Avalonic has an ancestor in this time period, Faye must have one. Granted, we're on the wrong planet. Maybe he's from Phalamorbius. He doesn't look the most human, but...
Lady Relaya, I truly apologise for all of the trouble.
Kneel!
You've caused too much trouble for the princess.
Oh my, please forgive me. Tomica.
How dare you speak on my behalf?
Huh?
I do not recall asking for your opinion. I love this planet. I love all of our people too. This isn't a prison. I want everybody to enjoy their lives. People of Phalamorbius, as long as I am alive, I will ensure that everyone acts together as one grand community.
So this is Phalamorbius. Excuse me.
I tried not to laugh over the important scene, but I don't think that's quite how you're meant to ask somebody. Oh, and about the fountain, you're not allowed to jump in it. Saying specifically to JP. Again, JP so far has contributed nothing towards the matches. All he's done is eat our food and cause offence to the locals of other planets. You're beyond useless right now. Is everyone done here?
Yep, now we're free to explore. Kind of as we were doing before, but what should we do now?
Work! Never seen that icon from Keenan's face before. What is it? This is bad. I dropped my wallet. Not this again! Your wallet? Shh. Keep it down. You don't know who's listening.
Don't you remember when you had it last?
Well, we were at the central dome. I was checking out the fountains. Maybe it fell out over there.
The massive fountain?
Frank, if it's in the fountain, then you can find it.
Me?
We'd better hurry. Let's get back to the fountain.
Yep, Zippy lost his wallet in Chapter 1, so now it's time for the other member of our ISTJ squad to lose their wallet as well. I don't know if that actually is Keenan's personality type, but given that I am an ISTJ myself, I am willing to use it as an insult. Sorry to everyone else who shares the same personality type as me. But at least you know what Myers Briggs stuff is in the first place, so there you go. That's some more knowledge for you to soak in. Anyway, so let's find this wallet. It's not like it contains any sort of currency that we can use here anyway.
Keenan's wallet should be here somewhere.
So when we weren't even meant to go to this area before, and actively went out of our way to explore it, apparently we did need to go here because we've got official canon record of visiting here before to look for this wallet.
Ugh.
Hey, you can't do that! Swimming's not allowed here!
What? How did you know?
Tourists can be so annoying. Just don't do it!
Looks like my inference was correct. There's no mistake about it there.
Inference?
If my theory is correct, the Naiads can read minds.
They can read our minds?
What do you mean?
Frank was just looking at the fountain, how can one possibly tell what he was going to do? The only way to explain that is mind reading. Coincidence? I think not.
Maybe you're right. That explains why they were always one step ahead in the football battle.
That reasoning is just a little bit hazy.
Who are you?
What? Don't you know about Plink?
This is Plink I, captain of the Naiadi 11.
Naiadi 11?
I didn't expect this.
You guys don't have to talk. Plink can see everything.
You can see?
We have the ability to see the mind of the opponent with our...
You know, we've only just introduced the voice for Princess Rolea in this episode, and now we've got to do it again with an even more over-the-top girly girl. But here's Plink, and...
We have the ability to see the mind of the opponent with our eyes.
You can see our minds with your eyes? So you can't read them?
Something like that.
Do you know what an ether is?
You want to know about it? Fine, we'll tell you. Trickle, can you explain, please?
A source of ether is something that we can look at in order to either see the state of the mind.
I didn't really deliver that one too confidently, but I tell you something. Ether changes appearance along with one's mind. It can change to various different colours and shapes. If you're happy, your ether turns into a gentle colour and shape. If you become angry, the ether will turn dark and uneasy. This is how us naiads see the mind. We look at a person's ether.
So this is the power of the Naiadi. This is going to be tough, Falco.
Whatever.
There's a lot that we can see. Your ether is so dark and ugly. Plink has never seen anything like it. That ether is very interesting.
Indeed. Earth 11.
What is it?
Plink wanted to have a football battle.
It's no use trying to beat us, though. As long as we have the all-amazing Plink, we'll win!
We'll see about that.
Arian, I can't do this right now.
What?
I don't feel too good.
Oh, okay. Are you sure?
I'm sorry, but I just feel too sick to play today.
It's okay, man. I wasn't planning on fielding you anyway. I guess I should. We haven't used the imposter at all yet. Is it an imposter? Maybe that's the real Victor Blade. We know that he's on Phalamorbius right now. So, what do I actually want to use for this match? This is going to be tougher opposition than the previous random encounters, and Sean is all out of TP. I could go to the healing point, or I could just swap him out for Bylong. Frank actually has a shooting move, which is worth considering. It's not very strong at all, and Frank's kickstat is perhaps one of the lowest on the whole team at 35. Like, that's particularly bad, but we have Bylong with us, so I'll run the risk. Again, I think... Do you need to win this? I genuinely don't remember, but I'm quite curious to see if I will, because I've fielded quite a poor team, until it's now told me that Keenan is necessary for this one. So fine, never mind, Frank. I guess you'll get your chance another day. That will be fine. I hope. Cue the evil music for Beta 2.0. Yes, it's Beta, but an alien now. That's how I've always kind of seen Plink.
Let's go, guys. We need to attack and advance together.
Thank you, Han.
Did they see where he was going to pass to?
That's not all. We see your movement, your thoughts, everything.
Ah, blast!
Nice to be in the story for a moment anyway, eh, chaps? Why is Bylong turned old British? I'm not quite sure, but ugh, do they really see what we're thinking in our heads?
Does a person's ether come from their face or something?
Hey guys, attacking at the same time won't work. Can you try to be a little more beguiling and switch things up?
Let's play with them a little more. This is so much fun, huh?
You idiots don't know what you're doing. You don't know what you're in for.
My, my, I can't read today, don't you know? We're into free play. Can we do anything? Plink is a midfielder, so she just barely has enough in her to win that interaction. Falco has upgraded his dribbling game now that we've given him air ride, but he still doesn't have anything on a blocking front. Lissing Liquid Flow, a brand new special move. That's the only one that Plink can afford to do, but off it goes. That's actually a mega move as well. This character, Droplet, the NPCs were talking about her in the very train station. She's got a lot of fans. Yeah, as you can tell, the Naiadi 11, it's not all girls, but it's definitely got the strongest lean. Lots of seaside alien girls for everyone to enjoy. So I don't know what they're doing here. They keep passing to each other. We haven't been able to take the ball from them at all, but then they just keep passing to each other and running down the timer. Oh, why can't we just get the ball already? Why is this so difficult?
What are we going to do? How will we hide our ether? Maybe the key is not to think about it too much.
What a joke.
That ether, it's a complete mess. Very interesting. Oh my! Plink is interested. Interested in what? It's a secret. When this battle is over, Plink will fill you all in. Well then, let's just end this already. Okay. Earth 11, it's time to finish this once and for all.
They're coming. Watch out.
And we're going to see some shooting brilliance. Well, they're on full power, so we may well do. Plink, 39 TP, are you going to get some of it back? No, just a regular shot that's going to boost in power all the way up to 245. Yeah, we lost this one. Definitely not one you have to win. How could I be the worst player in the history of the world?
What just happened? Do you see how powerful we are now?
This is bad. They can see all of our plays before we even perform them. That looked too easy.
Who? Oh. Uh-oh.
Rondula.
Even if it was easy, wasn't it a bit of a stupid idea to play with the enemy before the match?
Plink doesn't think that it matters. We can predict their every move, remember? Also, it's interesting to see how a team plays before a match anyway. Who's she? She doesn't look like the other Naiads.
Who knows? She brings about a bad atmosphere, though.
Plink is not in the mood for this anymore. Let's go!
All right, then. Until tomorrow, Earth 11. Farewell.
Didn't even get to take a shot on that goalkeeper, and away he goes.
So that's the Earth 11. The match tomorrow will be easy.
Hey, who said that you're playing in the game tomorrow? Your ether, even though you smile and laugh, your mind is full of evil and malicious thoughts. Phantom Orbius, however strong you all may be, we don't need your help.
Suit yourself, you pathetic beings.
Plink!
What do you think of my power? How does it feel on the receiving end? That was fun. I guess I'll see you all tomorrow.
Is everyone all right?
Yeah, thanks, Sky.
They can see what we're thinking. How are we going to win this match?
We shouldn't worry about it right now. Let's head back to the Orient Express and think of something over there.
Keenan, did we even find you, Wally?
Oh, about that. That was all made up. I made up that scenario because it was part of my plan to expose the enemy's secret.
What? So I was just a part of your grand plan? You egghead, you owe me a dessert.
Oh dear.
Off he goes. He's raging, I'll tell you what.
So the Naiads can read minds, eh? Great.
But that will do for now. There's plenty more of the Naiadi planet to explore. We certainly haven't seen the full depths of it, but for now we will need to go back to the Orion Express to regroup and collect our thoughts on how on earth we're supposed to beat mind readers, because, I mean, they're mind readers. That's like beyond anything that we've ever been tasked with before. Like, the Silica guys, they were just kind of tough and they had a violent brute playing along with them, but mind readers in the second round of the tournament? I think this is the final chapter of the game, to be honest. How and they've got that Rondula person as well with a devilish looking whippersnapper. And it's also going to kill my voice because there's so many female characters in this chapter and they're going as high as possible. I was very grateful that I didn't have any Charisse lines because I don't know how I'm going to make her sound any different to Plink and Rolea, I'll be honest. Arian, So in the previous episode I said bye and then I went silent for 20 minutes, 20 seconds in the inner link being like the video's over. You may not have seen the part where only in the third Inazuma 11 Go game have they now started to do a bit of canon Sky has a crush on Arian stuff. You know, Arian thinks Princess Katara's quite pretty and now Sky's all jealous, and they did well to go two games without any kind of hints there because Arian and Sky is frankly the most obvious and boring partnership that you can possibly think of to put a simian ape in this world, but yeah, I'm afraid to say within the inner link only, the hints are here. But yes, we'll go back to the Orion Express in the previous episode, but there's one part of the inner link that I forgot to read. There is another competition route here, and it's in Dewdrop Crescent on Naiadi. So that is why the team level of we're recommended to be team level 30 for the next match. What are we right now? I'm saving on screen just to be a complete badass. Terrible idea, but we are level 26 and the opponent is level 30. We obviously have more of the planet to explore, but it is generally a good idea, I would say, to actually do a little bit of this competition route, particularly because it's the one that you usually have access to straight away. This guy is just straight up an alien. This is what the Storm Wolves looked like after they turned back into aliens. And fun fact, somewhere in this competition, you can actually fight against the Storm Wolves team of aliens as the team that they were meant to be. I think they're in this route. They don't have an official English name. We called them something I've forgotten, but this is where you do rematches against actual story teams like Fire Dragon and everyone that we played in the FFI Vision 2. Usually that kind of stuff is kept on Earth and you can do it like as soon as you finish the tournament. They make you wait a little bit longer here, but we can actually rematch them all in Naiadi, and they're higher leveled as well, so this is a great way to get closer to level 30. I don't feel the need to show this match, but given that Fake Victor is feeling ill, I can't remember if he will actually be participating in the next match or not. They may actually not let you. So just to be sure, I am going to use him in this competition route match and completely mess it up. Try again, Victor. You don't have a blocking move, so we might not even be able to take it from him. No, we will. So this is just to demonstrate his model looks different, but functionally he will work exactly the same as normal Victor and he'll even contribute to the leveling up of
the actual victor who's over in Phalamorbius right now. 248 power means this victor is totally usable, but I don't really feel too good using a fake victor in story matches. Like, look at this goal celebration, happy as heck. But why would he be? Why would he ever want to score a goal for us? It's just not in his nature. So I won't be using too much of Purple Eyes Victor. But it's good to show that he's at least here. He can even bring out his fighting spirit should you want him to. I'm going to end the video here after rapid fire. So I'm going to try and S rank this route and get us a bit closer to level 28. But yeah, so thanks for watching, and in the next episode we'll go back to the Orion Express to think how on earth we're supposed to beat mind readers, because that's a bit of a ridiculous request, all things considered. Samba! Strike! Eugene wanted to pad us out just that little bit longer. He really is going to participate in every match, isn't he? I've got him in the Ricardo spot as well, and I know I've got some Ricardo fans watching this. Oh no! Okay, I've made a bit of a mistake here. Dark Tornado, 405 power, and we don't have any shot blocks out. They just scored. I guess Eugene shouldn't be playing in the matches with us, huh? RIP. No S rank for me. God! Bye.